Hello and welcome everyone. So we talked about all different microservice patterns, CQRS, event driven, event sourcing, API gateway pattern and all, which are most commonly used. Now we will talk some practical terms, we will use some demos, we will write some Node.js services and we will try to create some kind of a demo. Before that, first we will understand what is Docker, Docker Compose. I already have a separate playlist where I have covered in detail about what is Docker, how to use Docker, Docker installation requirement, how to create containers, Docker images, building the image, creating the Docker file. Everything is covered in the detail. So in this video, we'll try to understand what is the use of Docker Compose for the microservices. Okay, so first of all, in simple terms, what is Docker? So Docker is primarily a container runtime. Okay, this means that Docker is a piece of software that is designed to implement and support containers. Coming to the containers, containers are nothing but the extended LXC technology, which is nothing but a small or mini Ubuntu system, mini Linux system, which can work as a full-fledged system where you can install the required applications. Even you can run the application, you can run the Node.js, Java, Python, any particular application on top of it. It's like a mini virtual machine you have, right? So Docker, it is a core. Docker allows you to run containers on systems. It also offers a variety of tools, creating, managing the containers and container images. Okay, so Docker is a runtime engine. Docker is a tool which is helping us to create, manage containers. And what is container? Container is a runtime to give that environment for your application. Okay, so it is actually currently standard, industry standard, and I have covered Docker in detail, what it is about. All the particular content I have covered in the Hughes playlist, okay, where I'm talking about from installation setup, basic introduction to what is the difference between virtual machines and Docker, why you need Docker, why you need Docker for your local development. If you have a team of 5 developers who are writing different services, then why it is important to have one single Docker Compose file to locally orchestrate all these different containers together. Okay, so these are just some simple links which I will be providing. So most of the time we always create applications which are using MySQL, MongoDB, Node.js, RabbitMQ, different services, right? And we can't install and can't run them on our host operating system. We want that there should be isolated containers running each and every service. I have a checkout service, product service, cart service, user management service, all are running as an independent host, as a mini container. Right, so Docker is providing us a way to create these Docker container runtime where my one Node.js application can live, my another Node.js application can live in another container, and those containers can talk to one another. I can have a MySQL container, MongoDB container sitting in a different runtime system. Okay, now I just need to establish a communication. I don't need to install all these applications or tools natively on the host operating system. What I need is a Docker tool which will help me to create these containers, and these containers can provide me these different services. MySQL, MongoDB, RabbitMQ, Node.js, Python, Java, all these applications can run on these containers then. Okay, So Docker is not only the tool which is doing all those things. There are other players also available in the market, which is Rocket and Containerd. Okay, these are actually another, you can say, vendors. So Docker is one of them. Rocket is actually created by CoreOS, designed with composability and security in mind. Containerd is another, you can say, tool which is emphasized simplicity, robustness and portability. Okay, so there are other container runtime engines, same as Docker. What they are giving you? They are giving you a runtime environment for creating the containers. Containers, now you understand what are the containers, like mini virtual machines we are creating to isolate our services from one another. And you can create n number of containers based on the resources which are available on your systems, but it is going to consume very less resources in compared to virtual machines which we were having earlier. Okay, so how actually we combine all these containers? These are independent containers, MySQL, Mongo, RabbitMQ, Node.js. We have to bundle them together through with the help of Docker Compose file. Okay, we will be writing one Docker Compose file which will be able to spin up Postgres, MySQL, Mongo, Node.js container inside a single common network. Okay, I have covered all these things inside this particular series, how to write Docker Compose file, how to spin up the containers inside a single Docker Compose file which will create a network, and there Node.js can talk to MySQL, Mongo, RabbitMQ, all these other dependent services because they are living in different containers. So container networking, volume mapping, port mapping, container Docker file, building Docker file and creating the containers, Docker container lifecycle, all these things are already covered. Okay, just have a look onto that. I will also share the link. Okay, so we will talk about that Docker Compose in coming videos. I have already created it, how to actually create a multi-container application with the help of Docker Compose. Thanks everyone.